9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1,
engage! Hello everybody, British Bob here, and of course Bruno the Bulldog. Today we're going to be making a big splash and diving down to Bikini Bottom to take a look at the SpongeBob Pineapple House playset with license sound. We'll then be moving across to Patrick's home and Squidward's home in order to have a look around their humble abodes. And last but not least, we'll be finishing at the Krusty Krab for a tasty morsel of a Krabby Patty and the chance to meet Mr. Krabs and all the locals. So put your wetsuits on and let's go. And here we are at Bikini Bottom. Starting on the left here, we have Patrick's brown rock. On the right, SpongeBob's pineapple. And in the middle, poor old Squidward's house, sandwiched between the two. So without further ado, let's go and see if SpongeBob and Gary are home. Gary, SpongeBob, long time, long time. I've got a few friends with me. Do you mind if we have a quick look around your house? Oh, fantastic. In that case, let's start with the bedroom. I said let's start with the bedroom. Now, who would live in a house like this? Exactly, SpongeBob. Here we have his alarm clock. And his bed, which I'm just going to give you an example of in a minute once we can get SpongeBob to fall to sleep. And last but not least, we have his chest, which I'm hoping we're going to find. Yes, a nice clean pair of Y fronts. Well done, SpongeBob. Okay, so now we're going to have an example of why SpongeBob is never late for work. Just got to wait for his alarm clock to go off and then we'll see how this bed works. Are you okay, SpongeBob? That was some fall. Okay, good to hear. In that case, let's go and have a look at the lounge. In here, we have a table with barbed hooks for feet and a purple shell ornament. We have a television set here, which has three channels. One of Patrick and SpongeBob, one of SpongeBob, and one of SpongeBob and Rainbows. And we also have a sound effects chair. So SpongeBob, could I just borrow you, please? Let's have a listen to what we have in store for us here. Oh, SpongeBob, really? I think they're enjoying the tour so far. Gary, a newspaper arrived for you. My pleasure, my pleasure. Let's go and have a look at the kitchen. Now, you can't be a fry cook like SpongeBob without having yourself a decent kitchen. Here he has a few spatulas ready to flip some Krabby Patties, and he also has himself a lovely big cooker with light and sound. So if you press this button, the hobs light up. But be careful not to touch hobs when they're on, they're very hot. He also has a lift in his kitchen so he can go up to the bathroom and back down. And last but not least, let's go and have a look at the bathroom. And here we have a lovely big bathtub with a big sunflower shower head and also a sink. So just remember, boys and girls, before your dinner, always wash your hands. And speaking of dinner, here's the lift all the way down to the kitchen. So that's the tour of SpongeBob's home. Gents, thank you for letting us look around. We're now off to meet your neighbours. See you in a bit. Oh, hello, Patrick. Fancy seeing you here. Is it okay if we come and have a look at your home? Fantastic. Okay, lead the way. And while Patrick's just nipped inside, let's have a look at the outside of his home. Well, it's a brown rock, really, with a yellow wind vane on the top. That's about it, really. Hello, Patrick. Good to see you. And I can see that you're doing what you do best, the art of doing nothing, with the bare essentials. So Patrick has a little chair here, which, Patrick, I'd just like to point out, you should be sitting on and not standing. Ask your mother or father. He also has a television set here where he's watching both himself and SpongeBob. And last but not least, a little yellow lamp to light his rock when the lid is down and it's dark. Well, Patrick, thank you very much for letting us have a look around. We're going to go meet Squidward and we'll see you later. Well, Patrick's rock didn't take very long to look around now, did it? Let's go see if Squidward's in. Squidward, are you home? Maybe he must be around the back. And here we have Squidward's house, and Squidward's here, relaxing on his sun lounger after obviously completing yet another self-portrait of himself. And he also has a bookshelf. So if we just have a quick look, here we have a few items at the top, a stereo or speaker system, and also some books in order for Squidward to feed his knowledge. And we'll just zoom in now and have a closer look at the house itself. So here we have the inside of Squidward's house. As you can see, he's got a nice roaring fire going here, and two self-portraits, one of many hundreds which I assume he's painted over the years. We also have a squid's head up the top here, a statue down here, and if you may have noticed, this looks a little familiar. It does look like the Moai heads that we see on Easter Island, which has two portholes for eyes and a door for the mouth. Well, I don't know about anybody else, but looking around those homes has given me a real appetite. Why don't we head on down to the Krusty Krab? SpongeBob, do you want to lead the way and fry up some Krabby Patties for us? Well, I don't know where SpongeBob's just gone, but I hope he comes back. So here we are outside the Krusty Krab. As you can see, it has a fair few flags across the front here. I've looked them up and they're actually Royal Naval Signalling flags, which stands for the letters AS, the letter H, the number 7, the number 1, and number 6, and it spells ASH716. I've looked it up and it means absolutely nothing. Speaking of nothing, there's not much going on out here. So let's open it up and go and meet everyone inside. Just look at the size of this thing. It's huge. It's like a TARDIS from the outside. Well, I'm glad to see SpongeBob's managed to make it here in one piece. So let's go and look at the three rooms. And here we have the main area of the Krusty Krab. Wow, isn't it busy today? Here we have Squidward on the cash register. We have the menu up here. The door here into the kitchen where we can hear SpongeBob furiously making as many Krabby Patties as possible. And speaking of Krabby Patties, we have two Krabby Patties, a box of French fries, some tomato sauce or special sauce. We've got Mrs. Puff, Bill and Patrick here ready to tuck into the delights of the Krusty Krab. And we also have Plankton down here who no doubt is trying to sneak into the kitchen to nick the secret formula. We also have a clock up here, and can anybody tell me the time? That's right, it's 2 o'clock. And if we just listen closely, I can hear some Krabby Patties sizzling on a hot plate. So let's go into the kitchen and meet SpongeBob. Hard at work, I see SpongeBob. Can I just borrow you for a second? Thank you. So here we have SpongeBob. He's got his little work cap on with an anchor on the top there and a metal spatula for flipping the patties. And here we have one right now cooking on the hot plate. So let's just try out this light and sound kit. There it is, sizzling nicely away there. We also have a Krabby Patty that SpongeBob made earlier, some tomato sauce, and it also looks as though SpongeBob is complying with health and safety and keeping the kitchen clean as we go. Anyway, thank you for letting us look round, SpongeBob. We're going to go and meet Mr. Krabs in his office. See you later. Hello, Mr. Krabs. British Bob here. How are you this merry day? Very good, very good. Could I just move you out of the way for a moment, please? So here we have Mr. Krabs' office, which is very modest to say the least. And it only has one item of furniture in it, a large chest or a trunk. But it's definitely full of money, isn't it? Well, Mr. Krabs, thank you very much for letting us have a look around your establishment today. And yes, we will remember to tip well on the way out. Well, that's just about it for this video. We hope you enjoyed your trip to Bikini Bottom with us today. Please remember to comment and subscribe, and we'll look forward to seeing you again in the next video. But not before we've had a lovely cup of tea. It's Southampton tea today. See you all again soon. Toodle-pip.